microfilm collection is very special.
Microfilm was one of the first formats to miniaturize books, papers, newspapers, to make them more accessible and take up less storage space. It takes a document and puts it onto the film, and you can see that it's in miniature.
Paper items like newspapers and books and things do take up a lot of room.
Just for comparison, this is 3 days worth of our current newspaper, the Topeka Capital Journal, and this is 1 month's worth on microfilm.
Another reason for microfilm is for preservation. Paper disintegrates, gets yellow.
It's also a lot lighter to carry 1 month of newspapers on a roll of microfilm than it would be to carry 30 of these. This is only three, so imagine a whole stack of 30.
Some of the things we store on microfilm are local newspapers. These, for instance, are issues of the Topeka Capital Journal, almost 5 years' worth in one drawer. If we had 5 years' worth of newspapers, we'd have stacks and stacks and stacks of paper turning yellow.
Each roll has 1 month's worth of newspapers. It does include all of the advertising sections, the TV guide, in addition to the main newspaper.
The microfilm we store in these cabinets represent almost 150 years of Topeka's newspaper history, but we also have other things stored on microfilm. It might be old plat books, which are map books of different counties. Another wonderful resource we have on microfilm are Topeka buildings permits that go back to the 1880s.
Some of the other things that we have on microfilm include Carrie Nation's Smasher's Mail, which was her newsletter around the turn of the 1900s that let people know about her anti-liquor campaigning. We also have just different other newsletters, newspapers. We have Construction News, which talks about buildings in more recent years in Topeka. We have smaller newspapers from the early parts of Topeka's history. Newspapers such as The Plain Dealer, The Commonwealth, and other smaller newspapers that were shorter run. This is one of our three microfilm machines. We pulled a roll of microfilm from May of 1954, the Topeka Daily Capital, which was the morning paper. And we load it onto the machine, and the machine helps us in some spots of it. We can zoom out a little bit here so we can see what it is, and we are going to be looking for the 18th. This has an entire month's worth of newspapers on it. And it was a Sunday, because I just saw all of the bride announcements. Ooh, there's
the
comics.
Can't forget the comics. Everything in the newspaper was microfilmed.
What happened on May 18th, 1954, that was significant to Topeka, Kansas, was the Brown versus Board of Education ruling. They were trying to desegregate the schools, and they were protesting that separate was not equal. This picture actually has three of the lawyers who fought for that battle in front of the Supreme Court.
We think that our microfilm collection is special because, for one thing, we have a long run, and we're talking over 100 years, of some of our newspapers.
One of the other things that we find the microfilm very helpful for is when you're looking for someone who lived here in Topeka, whether it be an obituary or whether it be a wedding announcement, birth announcement, those types of things. When you know the date in the paper, you can look at the paper and find the information about your family or about a business. We do have an obituary index that does help point you to the right place for the obituaries that appear in the newspapers here locally in Topeka and Shawnee County, and that index is on our website.
Things that are available only miles and miles away or at other institutions are available to us right here on the spot. And that's what we're all about, preserving the information and making it accessible to people that want to know about these things.